Good morning students, welcome to online classes presented by Mr. Ravi S. Kumar, lecturer in Department of Studies in Commerce, KLX Kote College of Commerce, Belgaum. Dear students, today class we are going to discuss about accounts of a doctor and also accounts of a lawyer. So before going to discuss accounts of doctor and lawyer, so we discussed in the previous class regarding accounting for chartered accountant. And so whatever I had given information regarding the accounts of chartered accountant, just to go through that, especially that working note and key note, you go through that, you will be understood clearly. Even though if you're not understanding, please comment me, I will be just, because those key points or working notes are very important for the at the time of solution of the problems. And already told you in the previous class again, out of three, the professional list, the main important is what, a chartered accountant, second important is doctor, and third is a little bit important is what, a lawyer. Let us start with the doctor. You see, every medical practitioner or doctor has his own income and expenditure in course of his professions. To ascertain the net result of a profession and financial position on a particular date, the medical practitioner has to maintain the necessary books of accounts or register and other documents, etc. So because why the doctor has to maintain the books of accounts and register and other document, because he has to come to know that the net result of his profession, net result of his profession in the sense of what, he come to know that how much is the expense has to be done and how much is my net income of a doctor professions. Because of that, the doctor has to maintaining the certain accounting aspects. Is it clear the introductory aspect of accounting for doctor? Every medical practitioner, every doctor, they have an income and expenditure, but they have to know, come to know that exact income and exact expenses. Because of that, they are going to maintaining certain books of accounts, and whatever they are maintain the books of accounts, we have to use it, and then we have to prepare what, income and expenditure account and balance sheet. By preparing the income and expenditure account balance sheet, we will come to know that the what is the exact net income, what is the exact net expenditure of that accounting professions. Is it clear? We'll move to the next. So that is the books of accounts to be maintained by what, the doctor. See, as per the rule of every medical practitioner are required to keep the maintaining certain books of accounts and register. However, the cash book and stock register of drugs, medicine and accounts of professions are should be maintained. But basically, the chartered the doctor, the accounting for medical practitioner or doctor, they have to keep and maintain certain books of accounts. In that special is what, the cash book and stock register of drug. Stock register means they have to, this is most important, stock register, because when you talk about doctor has to maintain certain the stock register book, especially in the water, how much drugs he have that and how much the medicine he have that. And regarding that, how much he has to use for personal and professional purpose. So because of that, he has to maintain stock register. When you, in the point of view doctor, the stock register and drug is most important working aspects. And again, the next is what, the cash book. What is cash book? You know, people, cash book is what? See, it is a summary of all receipts and all payments made by the doctor and posted to the respective account in the ledger account. However, the columnar cash book should be prepared to record the income and expenses, which helps the prepare the results and payments account of the profession. So that is a cash book. It's very simple scenario. The cash book is a summary of cash book, summary of all the cash transactions, cash receipts and cash paid, has to be done by what, a doctor. And next one is what, because you know people, so only I'm not given any the textual information regarding cash book. Next one is what, a stock register. This is the most important. See, every medical practitioner should maintain the stock register of the drug or medicine, etc., with required columns to record the purchase and sale or issue of drugs or medicines and other consumable accessories. So these register should contain the details as to the date of purchase, short description, quality, or the number of numbers or price, amount, etc. It has to be maintained in that register of the medicines, and also the name and address of the supplier. The proper entries have to be made in this register as and when the ड्रग्स एंड मेडिसिंस एक्सेट्रा आर परचेज और इशूड फॉर कंजम्पशन इन द हॉस्पिटल और क्लिनिक फॉर यूजिंग इन द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ पेशेंट्स. So these all will be included under the OTRE. Because of that, we are going to maintaining the stock register. In the sense of stock register, it may be drug related or it may be medicine related or any other consumable related. If the doctor has to maintaining or used, so for that related, he has to maintain a stock register. Because whatever the drug, whatever the medicine and whatever the consumable items, if he is maintained for the purpose of what? For the treatment of a patient only. Na? So obviously, this register show opening stock and closing stock of the items, and they should be valued on the proper basis and incorporated in the books of account. The following adjustment entry will be done. The first entry is what? So first entry, adjustment of opening stock. How we are going to adjusting opening stock? So income and expenditure account debit to opening stock account means the whatever we have opening stock the regarding that register, first we have to debit to the income and expenditure account and credit to the opening stock account. And same like adjustment of the closing stock is what? The closing stock account debit to income and expenditure account credit. And next, that is the most important, household expenses or incomes. See, what will happen? The treatment of the family members. So what will happen? Being a doctor, if you made any treatment for the family members, so that is to be what? Personal. So that is to be what? Considered as a drawings. Simple sense I will tell you. The whatever the drugs and whatever the medicines are available in the hospital or clinic, but whatever he purchased the drugs, medicine and some of the consumable items for the purpose of patients, but the whatever the in the name of patient he has using for what a family members treatment, so that is to be wrong. So whatever he done that is to be considered what a drawings. Because personal, right, is for the purpose of family members, that is to be personal. Next, purchase of instruments. If you purchase any instrument in the name of hospital, so that is to be what added to the capital account. Because if you take an example of clinic or hospital, so we need many of the instruments, many of the furnitures we have to be required in the hospitals. So at the time, the doctor may be purchased in between. So that is to be purchase of any instrument is to be considered what additional capital is added to the what his investment of the capital in the balance sheet. So this is a brief introductory about what a doctor. That is main important this regarding drawings and additional capital regarding the adjustment of drugs, medicine and stocks. Let us move to the next, that is accounts of a lawyer. See, according to the lawyer, so what it is? Lawyer are the person who are engaged with the legal matters on affairs and earn their livelihood from the same. They are also called advocates. They are engaged in rendering the services to the clients by fighting case in the favor. So this is a brief introduction about what a lawyer. As you know, you people, what is a lawyer? What lawyer will be do? The things used to be explained in the introductory. So lawyer is a person and he is always engaged with the legal aspects, legal matters. And he is involving under the legal aspects, he is earned the money to running his livelihood. And also the lawyer will called as advocates. And these are engaged in the what rendering the services for the clients by fighting the case in the favor of a client only. We'll move to the books of accounts and accounting aspects for the lawyer. So being a lawyer, he has to maintain the following the books of account. One is client ledger he has to be maintained. Second one is a client disbursement ledger. And third one is a client's control account. And fourth one is provision for unrealized profit. So what happened about the client ledger? In one word, I will explain one or two words. See, client ledger contains a separate account for each client. Cash received from client is credited to the in client ledger account and three columns are provided on the debit side of the accounts such as out of pockets, fees and total. So this is a personal account. It may shows either debit balance or credit balance side of the balance sheet. This is a client ledger. It's very simple. Client ledger is a ledger account. It has to be maintained in the name of client only. Whatever the fees received or whatever it is the fees relating to the out of the pocket relating to the client, that is to be recorded at the client account. Next, client disbursement ledger. So what will happen under this? For the purpose of making payment on behalf of the client, a separate account is opened called client disbursement account. So in the name of client, on the behalf of client, we have to pay certain expenses, certain payments to the other party. In that moment, we have to prepare this account. Next, client's control account. See, according to the client's control account, this account is opened by the lawyer who have maintained general ledger, in which case the client's personal ledger is also be separately maintained. Since to maintaining the client activities, general ledger, we have to maintain the separate account, that is general client control account. So next, provision for unrealized profit. So what will happen under this case? So when the amount is not yet collected from the client for the work completed, the proper provision has to be made. Similarly, the work in progress at the closing of the year, for which amount yet to be received, also needs some amounting of provisions. So that is to be what a provision for unrealized profit. This is very simple. Provision for unrealized profit means the lawyer has done the work. Lawyer has done the work, but the client is not yet paid the payment. Lawyer has done the work, the payment is not yet collected from the client. In that moment, if the payment is not realized from the client, that is to be unrealized profit. And the whatever, when the amount is not collected from the clients, that is to be on that made, the lawyer is going to make his what, the provision, that is provision for unrealized profit. Similarly, best example, work in progress at the closing of the year. So at the end of the year, we have to record is what, a work in progress. And provision for unrealized profit is shown on the liability side of the balance sheet. So whatever the provision is there, that is to be shown on the what, a liability side of the balance sheet. Next, so there is an entry for that income and expenditure account debit to provision for unrealized profit account. So this is a brief introductory about books of accounts for the doctor and lawyer. We completed. So the today the theoretical concept is purely completed. From tomorrow, let us start with the problems. First, I will teach you the 5 marks problems and theoretical questions. And later, we will shift to what 15 marks problems on one by one. Chartered accountant, doctor and lawyer. The chapter is very easy and very interesting. Just to go through my instruction, definitely we will be understood that. And thank you. We will meet in the next class.